was a targeted response. I think we tried to identify the exact problems that were happening within corporations and address those problems.
Financial statements, financial information is a product or series of products, and it's derived from a supply chain. You've got the standards by which the information needs to be prepared and disclosures need to be prepared. You've got the companies with their systems, their controls, their, you know, efforts to prepare the information. You then have the auditors, you know, looking at it, doing their audits, and you've got audit committees overseeing the whole process. Sarbanes-Oxley, I think, pretty forcefully touched each of those aspects of the supply chain.
I think when you look at internal controls and the number of restatements that has dropped dramatically since Sarbanes-Oxley was passed, I think by that measure alone, you can see that the quality of reports has improved. And I also think just in discussions that we have with public companies, they have come to appreciate the importance of internal controls in their own practices, particularly over the last 15 years.
The financial reporting is much richer today, I think not only in this country, but I think around the world. Both regulators and companies themselves have begun to do much more open, robust disclosure than they did in the past. I think that's all to the good, for example. I think a number of things that Sarbanes-Oxley did with increasing the kinds of things that are disclosed has been very, very, very helpful to us.
I think financial reporting and public company auditing is the strongest that it's been, certainly since the passage of Sarbanes-Oxley. However, we also have empirical data to show that as well, whether it's the CAQ's Main Street Investor Survey, which we conduct every year, and this year, confidence in our capital markets is the highest that it's been since we began doing that survey 10 years ago. It's also the auditors, independent public company auditors, are the entity that investors think have their interests at heart the most. So I think those are two really important data points.
If you look at the financial crisis of 2007 and 2008, one of the things that went unchallenged was the veracity of financial reporting. There were a lot of other issues, but it wasn't the accounting profession, and it wasn't the audit profession that was found to be at risk or lacking. So I think the marketplace has determined that there's a new confidence there, and a restored confidence, if you will, that has happened.
Today, I think the culture is just totally different in terms of financial reporting.
I think that Sarbanes-Oxley did have the advantage. It was bipartisan legislation, genuinely bipartisan legislation, so there wasn't the same sort of polarization in that way. And I think, you know, it's basically in the interest of good controls. It was pursued in the interest of good controls. I think there was more consensus.
Its principles have spread throughout the world. They've been adopted by other countries throughout the globe, and also by nonprofits. A lot of nonprofits now voluntarily comply with Sarbanes-Oxley principles, and that's been very gratifying to those of us who worked on the bill. So again, the bipartisan nature of it, I think that it advanced and improved corporate governance and the operations of boards of directors, and in general, the gatekeeping that surrounds the functions of public companies. So I think those improvements have been recognized and replicated.